Hello and welcome to the SciFirst Movie Talk episode. So I'm back in this episode playing Disney's The Haunted Mansion on the PlayStation 2, for a PlayStation 2, based on the 2003 film, I believe, with Eddie Murphy, and indeed the ride at one of, I still haven't looked it up, one of the Disney theme parks, or maybe more than one, I don't know. Doesn't they have it at Disneyland Paris, so it's not that one. But nonetheless, yes, based on the popular Disney ride nonetheless. So this has been an absolutely fantastic game, but we are here at the end. This is the 8th episode. This is it. I can tell you now, the levels that I'm playing here are the final levels. We get to face the big bad at the very end. This has been an absolutely fantastic game. It's sort of a cross hybrid between a puzzler and a platformer. Some very taxing levels that we've passed. Indeed, the ones in this episode aren't as taxing as I thought they might be. It's more an all-out assault with the bad guys and the critters and the creeps than anything else. So a bit disappointed there that the last couple of levels, are a little bit more easier in terms of the brain level required, but sort of like firepower now. It's more about the firepower. And indeed, the final boss is just a case of blasting him silly. So, yeah, a bit of an end that I wasn't kind of expecting. I was expecting some big puzzle box cube thing to do, but never mind. It's still fantastic, still had a brilliant time. It was still a lot of fun to play, and I still don't regret any part of this game. It has been an absolute blast. What I would say is that if you watched the last episode, I've literally got one life left, I think, and the system isn't telling me that because everything's gone all screwy. But I have like one life left. I could not do this level with the onslaught that was required. So I had to activate a cheat. I had to activate invincibility. But I believe that only worked for one level. And as you'll see, I think, because when you get invincibility, you can't collect the little life potion things. But it allowed me to do that in the very last level. So I think I lost my invincibility for the boss and I still cleared him. So hey, I hope you enjoy that. But like all the other episodes in this series, all the way through, I've recorded them extremely late at night, so don't adjust your telly, don't adjust your computer speakers or whatever. You're not going mad. I am just not saying anything. It's my own personal do not make a noise challenge, and I think I've done pretty well all the way through here. I'm up to the very final bit without kind of waking anybody up, which is always good. Everybody else is in bed. But yes, hope you enjoy it, but please don't adjust. There's no reason to. Hopefully enjoy the game nonetheless instead of just watching my ugly mug. But yes, thank you very much for joining me. Enjoy the game. Enjoy the levels that are to come and the very final big boss battle.
Has returned and claimed some of the laborers, but not before they completed their task. Recovery of the beacon's soul gems is now imperative, as is the gathering of the final ingredients. The gems were scattered in an attempt to thwart me. My minions still have not been able to deliver them. Perhaps there is another.
Thank you. needed the pirate's death certificate.
Whichever it is, matey. I was starting to think maybe you wasn't going to make it this far. Oh, now what's this? Ah, my death certificate. Yes, this is how I lost me treasure. A mutiny it were, a bunch of whiners. I always gave them a fair share. Say, matey, you found any of me lost treasure yourself? Well, if you do, you go ahead and keep half, which is 40%, you know. And just to show I'm a man of me word, I'll give you this here ring. It's a signet ring. Belonged to a member of that Order of Shadows, it did. Use it well, and if, when you come back, I'll cut you in for half the loot. Like I said, a full 30%. In fact, I could always use a good first mate. That is, if you're still in need of gainful employment when this is all over. Keep that in mind. Half of the loot for me first mate, 20%, and not a penny less.
The markings on this ring seem familiar. The foyer, that's it? This ring is the key to the device in the foyer. We must return there.
Thank you.
Good, good. You've brought them to me.
You will never get away with destroying the afterlife as long as we're here, Thorn.
Afterlife, my dear sweet Leota. Think you that my ambitions stop merely at death's door? Oh, no, no, no. Why settle with conquering the realm of the dead when the land of the living is practically within my reach? No more of this confusing life, after death nonsense. I'm afraid from now on, it's just death, death, and more death.
Seek the beacon!
I'll be taking that if you don't mind. Your efforts are greatly appreciated, Zeke. You've collected a great deal of souls for me, not to mention all of the legendary soul gems. And thank you, my loyal minions, for giving yourselves willingly to my cause. With the energy of these souls, I will have enough power to bring darkness and decay over the heavens and the earth.
No!
I won't be needing this trinket anymore. Truly, everything that lives dies if you give it enough time. But patience, I'm afraid, is one of the many virtues you'll find that I, well, lack. From the mightiest king to the tiniest sparrow, all will become nothing but ashes, dust, and food for worms. Ah, yes. In the end, the worm conquers all. And my feast has just begun. Oh, I'm afraid your precious beacon is quite powerless without its crystal core.
Well, what are you doing? Whoa!
Oh, the souls, the suffering is beautiful, powerful, but there's still room for at least one more.
Thank you. doggy. Now that was some shooting.
Zeke?
Ooh, Mustang, the wind knocked right out of his sails.
Oh dear. It is gone.
It was an honor to have served with him.
Bravest fella I ever met.
He did sort of grow on you after a while, poor little beggar.
Zeke! Oh, we thought we'd lost you.
You were victorious! Atticus Thorn and the Order of Shadows will trouble us no more.
Thanks to you, Zeke, and Madam Leota.
Leota? Madam Leota, are you there?
Woo-hoo! Take that, you bloated sack of souls!
Leota!
What? It's over already? Did we win?
Yes, it's over, and everything's fine. More than fine now. They're free, Leota. The souls. You freed them all.
With their troubles finally put to rest, the ghosts resolved to haunt the mansion together, for now and ever after. I made up my mind to stay on for a time as caretaker of the estate, and afterwards, with the blessing of Madame Leota and the others, I continued to pursue my dream of becoming a writer. Only many years later did I come to understand how, on that dreary October afternoon when I first opened the door to that haunted mansion, I had opened the door to the rest of my life.
As the moon climbs high o'er the dead oak tree,
spooks arrive for the midnight spree. Creepy creeps with eerie eyes start to shriek and harmonize. Grim, grinning ghosts come out to socialize.
The crypt doors creak and the tombstones quake.
Spooks come out for a swinging wake. Happy haunts materialize and begin to vocalize. When grinning ghosts come out to socialize.
Now don't close your eyes and don't try to hide.
Or a silly spook will sit by your side. Shrouded in a daft disguise. They pretend to terrorize. Grim, grinning ghosts come out to socialize.
When you hear the knell of a requiem bell,
weird ghosts scream where spirits dwell. Restless bones etherealize. Rise as spooks of every size. Grim, grinning ghosts come out to socialize. Grim, grinning ghosts come out to socialize.
Thank you.
So yeah, what did I say? An absolute onslaught. And basically, like I said, not really meant to the puzzles. It was just a case of keep going with the baddies, keep going with the baddies, keep slinging things at them and hope for the best. And that is literally how we ended this game, which was a bit of a disappointment considering everything that we've had to go through to get there. But nonetheless, it was exciting. It was enticing nonetheless. And it has been a fantastic game through and through. So I can't fault that. Most games don't end very well when all said and done. Most series don't end very well nonetheless. But yeah, so we've had fantastic fun. I've had a brilliant time with this. And like I said, I did have to activate a cheat towards the end. I don't think it worked on the last level, so I think I defeated the boss. I'm going to say I defeated the boss on my own. I let the titles roll without my picture because I thought, well, I'm just going to sit there looking stupid, watching them doing nothing. So that's why I did that. I hope you've enjoyed this game as much as I have. It's been an absolute blast. But that's it. That is it. That is the end of this video, the end of the series. It's the Haunted Mansion has been completed, at least in easy mode. But yes, I play them for fun. I don't play them to beat records and all the rest of it. So I'm happy. I'm happy that I did it in easy mode, nonetheless. What I was going to say. So yeah, so the next episode, I'm probably going to piece together all the bits that I did right, all the puzzles, so that at least you can see them in all the glory, shall we say, sort of like the walkthrough level. And then we'll be on to something new, something interesting. And I think I know what it's going to be. So yeah, look out for that. It'll be absolutely fantastic. Something a little bit akin to this. You'll see. But anyway, thank you very much for watching. I do hope you enjoyed it. If you have, please leave a like. Please do hit that subscribe button for more movie reviews, trailer actions, and other movie-related content. Absolutely loved having you at SciFirst Movie Talk. Definitely love to have you back. Most of all, just thank you very much for watching. Goodbye.